I've got a bunch of obsidian and glass slabs. This one looks like it's obsidian, that I promised I would nap on video. And I'm going to try the steel tools with this, just to see how far I can get. I normally don't nap slabs because these have already been pretty much mastered by a certain type of flint napping involving heavy pressure and long narrow flakes and a notched pad. But I'm going to be using this pad for napping. It's not going to be ideal, and it's not going to be the way that is most efficient, but I'm going to try it anyway. This has already been roughened up on the edges just for that purpose, for a copper napping tool, heavy pressure or ishi stick, to run long narrow flakes across faces first and then dress up the edges later. It's about a quarter inch thick, and you know, 1 7/8, almost 2 inches wide, which is a little bit too risky for me. I usually don't do this kind of thing, but I'll try it anyway. I try not to nap materials that have a very high likelihood of breaking, especially knowing that I tend to get frustrated with glass, and I'll be a little bit too aggressive and snap the whole thing. I'm not going to run flakes across the surface. I'm going to zigzag the edges. If I can. I'm going to use a previous flake scarf as a platform. And Ishii did the same thing. He would use a previous flake scarf for a platform when he was napping his glass glass points. Of course, he would be using the famous Ishii stick named after him with a long handle, but I just got short handle ones for now. Probably should make a batch of long handled pressure flakers. Now I am going to lose a substantial amount of the edge. But it's okay. The more narrow it is, the easier it's going to be to run flakes across the surface. Get rid of those scratch marks or the tool marks. I'm probably not going to leave the tip that pointy. I can already feel the flakes bouncing off the pad into my face and all around. Probably need to get a face mask. I normally try to set up differently for glass napping. I'll put a cloth down or something to catch the flakes that go, you know, across the floor, across the room. I have a bigger area than this little cowhide here, but I won't be napping too much glass, at least not yet. Maybe, well, in future videos I'll probably do a whole series, but I just wanted to try this today and see how it works. I've got some free time today. and a lot to catch up on. I gotta watch as we get further down, I gotta watch I don't scrape up against that tip like I just did. Let me put a band-aid on that, so I'll put a band-aid on it so you don't have to watch the whole video. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna I'm going to round off that tip. The final point is not going to be that long. I don't want it to be that long. Now, I thought about beveling it in one direction, but I think that would take a lot more force. And I don't want to snap the slab. The angle on this has to be just right. It puts me dangerously close to the tip. I guess I could start with, but even if I start on the other side, I'm still going to run the risk of hitting the corner. I may have to just do that anyway since I've stalled it. Just a lot of the same thing over and over. Some guys are a master at doing this. I'm one of those people where it drives me crazy. But this is just the first point, so it's not too bad. If I was doing it maybe 5 points at a time, it gets old quick. Okay, so that's that edge. I'm going to start from the back side again. This looks like triple flow, which is some of my favorite obsidian. It's a, not because of the color, but because it's very elastic in most cases. And it makes nice flakes. Trying to keep that new edge along the center and not get too close to either side. If I get too close to one side, it's difficult to remove a flake for the next flip over of the freeform. Okay, you gotta watch out for these. That type of flake usually ends up where it shouldn't be. If I wait too long to brush off those flakes, they tend to migrate down into my glove. And then right when I need to apply pressure on the pad, it'll be underneath the pad, and you know what happens after that. Now you might be saying, isn't it easier just to try running flakes across the surface? Well, maybe. I don't think it is, because then you end up trying to nap a very thin piece. You know, if you run flakes across, unless they're extremely shallow, your piece is going to be very thin. And then you're going to be inevitably looking at a step fracture or some other defect near the center that you've got to run a big flake to try to wipe it out, and you've already got a really thin piece, and you'll break it when you try to do your damage control and eliminate that mistake. I prefer with glass anyway, I prefer to leave it as thick as possible until the very end because of damage control. You want to leave yourself some thickness to run long flakes to clean up the surface if you have to. But that's why guys get good at running perfect long flakes in the beginning, so they don't have to deal with any surface imperfections later. And they're just very careful about dressing up the edges. It's kind of a methodical, very systematic way of doing it, which is kind of opposite of my style. Okay, so it's just a matter now of picking out some platforms, running long flakes. I do need to make sure I got the overall shape that I want. I think it's still too long for me. Not very many points in the archaeological record are this pointy. Usually the edges are, they curve inward toward the point. Instead of perfectly straight like this. And they sell slabs that are already cut to that arch shape. If you are going to buy slabs, I recommend that shape anyway. Just because there's less likelihood of breaking. Now with smaller slabs, it's not too bad. There's a lot of obsidian points that are nice and delicate, and you know, you want to get your hands on a nice long narrow slab for those, or cut glass in long narrow slabs. Okay, I might make an elko out of this too, since they were made of obsidian in many cases. We got plenty of room. I don't need these corners for that style. So for now, I'm just not going to worry about the surface yet. I'm just going to worry about getting everything else looking correct. I'm going to try some indirect percussion and see how that works. It's just opportunistic flaking. Of course, I am hitting the areas that I abraded earlier, just before this step. Crush a lot of the edge on here, so I might have to take a lot of that edge off. Probably should have started with the base first. Well, it's kind of a good idea to thin the tip out just a little bit so you don't have as much mass hanging off the end here to cause it to snap in the middle. Now, I am getting crushing, but I'm gonna get rid of that stuff later. Even if I had to make the tip shorter or whatever, I'll get that later. I'm not worried about that stuff. Even though it is annoying to get the crushing, steel is going to do that anyway. Not too sure how I'm going to get rid of that, but I'll figure it out. I'll just adjust my technique slightly to overcome those mistakes. One good thing about good quality obsidian is it allows you to do damage control. It allows you to do long or tricky flakes that you couldn't normally do on raw stone or chert. So if you make a mistake on glass or obsidian, the good quality stuff, not that difficult to repair. It's also easy to make a mistake. I could thin this down too much by mistake. Or hit way too hard and pop the tip off while I'm striking the base. But with a hard tip flaker, there's less shock than if I were to use a soft tip flaker to do this. I don't know if you guys can see. It's hard to see the contours, I think, for you guys. But I'm just thinning it down without thinning it too much. Yeah, I just looks like all I need to do is another just one more pass on this side and one more pass on that side to get rid of the tool marks. But I've got to turn the edges and dress it up a little bit before I do those last two passes to clear the surface. Need to use the flat. Hopefully I'll get rid of some of those crushings that I did. Those flakes are sneaking up on me. Sometimes I remember to buy the gloves with a little little tighteners on them, but not this time. I think you can see what I did there. Okay. And I'll take one off the other side if I see an opportunity. And it's possible to space these out because these percussion flakes on glass are going to be pretty wide. So I'll space them out, and if I don't get everything, I can go back and do a shorter, smaller flake to catch the rest of it. Unless the platforms are not strong enough. That platform wasn't strong enough. Those are nice, the ones that come from the corner. I think I got it all. You can put a more force on the flakes, the ones that come up from the corner, than you can the ones from the side or the base, at least in my experience. I'll refine the tip later. I just had some crushing there, so I was trying to get rid of it, but I'll do that later. So I'm slowly increasing the force that I use to try to get those flakes to come off and create a nice pattern. Just pretend that the steel is something soft and not worry too much about the way that steel crushes the edge. As long as the platforms are good, as long as you're not applying too much aggressiveness, you know, if I was hitting steel on steel like that to try to remove flakes, I think it'd be too much, but using the plastic is not so drastic. Almost got it. Yeah, I got enough thickness on the other side. I can get that later.